الحمد لله، الحمد لله الكريم الوهاب الرحيم التواب غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Dear brothers, dear sisters in Islam, we have to know that أشرف العلوم and the best knowledge you can know and you can have in your life, that knowledge will lead you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala عز وجل He did create us for a mission. If I ask you, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did create you for what? To eat, to play, to drink. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Dhariyat, وَمَا خَلَقَتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I have created jinn and the human being or the ins just to worship me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. If I ask you another question, who get the benefit of this ibadah? When you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 24/7, did you give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala any benefit? Or do you think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will get any benefit from you? No. The benefit of your ibadah, it's going back to you. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He sent the revelation, the system, the law, His system, His manual for us, because He's our creator, to fix our life. If you go into that system, your life will be fixed. That's why the one who get the benefit of this ibadah, you, not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah is ad-dar, Allah is an-nafa. Means you come to this life as a Muslim or as a human, especially our Muslims. From the time of your birth and the time you die, in between of two of them, there is two dots when you come to this life, the date of your birth and the day when you die. Ask yourself, what did you do? Are you someone very positive? He's benefiting himself and his family and his community and his Muslim ummah? Someone he can be positive in his society? Someone he's connected to himself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You see the baby in the uterus or the womb of his mother? Subhanallah, the baby is connected to his mother with the umbilical cord, right? To get his food, blood. And subhanallah, the same thing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after you come to, when you come to this life. You have to be connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The baby, he cannot live in the womb of his mother without that umbilical cord. The same thing you, this dunya, your kharban, big kharban, if you did not connect yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Through the ibadah and being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To know more about Allah azza wa jal, the one who did create you. Otherwise, you lose. Lost. Yes. That's why, dear brothers, dear sisters, we have to know that. The one who get the benefit of the ibadah, you, not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are you somebody positive? Somebody he can leave something behind his back when he die from his good deeds, or someone he's leaving after his death, backbiting, slandering, harming people, taking their rights or shedding their blood, or taking their properties or money, as somebody negative, somebody bad. That's why Allah said in Surah Yasin, what did Allah say? Inna nahnu nuhyi al-mawta wa naktubu ma qaddamu wa atharahum. This is my point here. Wa atharahum wa kulla shay'in ahsaynahu fi imamin mubin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, verse number 12, in the chapter of Yasin, Surah Yasin, surely we will resurrect the dead on the day of resurrection, and we record all the deeds they have done, good and bad. What they leave behind in this earthly life, like an obedient, believing child, charity of long lasting, stand, planting trees, trees, good inherited knowledge, all of these positive things, this is your athar, finger burnt before you leave. This is your fingerprint. This is what you have to leave as Muslim. Otherwise, if you make bad deeds like disobedience to Allah and the prophets, or bad, harmful knowledge or acts, all we gathered in a secret, truthful book. Brothers and sisters, we have to know that, subhanallah, me and you, we are going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the good thing is, alhamdulillah, we're still alive and we are in the month of Sha'ban. And Rajab, Sha'ban, Ramadan, this blessed month, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to make dua when he used to see the moon of Rajab. And he used to say, Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa balighna Ramadan. Oh Allah, bless us with the month of Rajab and Sha'ban and give us life, Ya Rabbil Alameen, to be in the month of Ramadan to worship you. That's why, dear brothers, don't be heedless. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran,
وَهُوَ الَّذِي جَعْلَ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ خِلْفَةً لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يَذَّكَّرَ أَوْ أَرَادَ شُكُورًا وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا وَالَّذِينَ يَبِيتُونَ لِرَبِّهِمْ سُجَّدًا وَقِيَامًا وَالَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا اصْرِفْ عَنَّا عَذَابَ جَهَنَّمْ إِنَّ عَذَابَهَا كَانَ غَرَامًا إِنَّهَا سَاءَتْ مُسْتَقَرًّا وَمُقَامًا.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save me and you and all of Muslim Ummah from the hellfire, Ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enter Jannah without any hisab, accountability, without any punishment, Ya Arhamar Rahimeen. Dear brothers, subhanallah, Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, هَلْ أُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِخَيْرِكُمْ. Should I tell you, Rasulullah said that to the Sahaba, who's the best amongst you? They said, Na'am ya Rasulullah, bala. Tell us ya Rasulullah, please. He said, Khiyarukum atwalukum a'maran wa ahsanukum a'mala. The best amongst you, those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them long life while they are doing good deeds. They are the best. They are the best, subhanallah. And Rasulullah said in that authentic hadith also, اغتنم خمسا قبل خمس. Take advantage of five before the coming of five. صلى الله عليه وسلم said, what? شبابك قبل هرمك. That time you are youth before you become old. That time you are healthy before you become sick. صحتك قبل سقمك. That time you are rich before you become poor. غناك قبل فقرك. And فراغك قبل شغلك. That time which is you have a spare time before you become busy. In general, he said, وَحَيَاتِكَ قَبْلَ مَوْتِكَ. In general, your life before your death. Why Rasulullah said that? Because now I am youth. I can do too many things. When I become old, I need somebody to carry me. No, there is no chance for you anymore. And he said, صَحَّتِكَ قَبْلَ سَقَمِكَ. The same thing. I am healthy. I can do too many things. So you see somebody now in the hospital, and they cannot do nothing. They need somebody to serve them. غِنَاكَ قَبْلَ فَقْرٍ. Today I have money. I can make charity and I can make sadaqah. I can make too many good deeds. Might be I will lose everything. And you see in overseas, our countries, especially Arab countries now, this country was like this and became people that are now homeless and they are refugees. Different, they die in the ocean. And you see all of that, right? Now you have money. Go make sadaqah, charity. Help someone in his life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you. Subhanallah. And you're going to get hasanat. طب what about فراغك قبل شغلك. Now I have a spare time. Might be I'm going to be busy in my life in the future for my kids or my job or whatever. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Rasulullah,
ألم نشرح لك صدرك right؟ ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقذ ظهرك. وكان في وزر أنقذ ظهر رسول الله جبريل when he used to come in the beginning with the revelation with the الوحي. It was hard for رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم because he never used to get the وحي before. That's why it was hard for him. It was heavy. إن سنلقي عليك قولا ثقيلا. But رسول الله later Allah made it easy for him. الذي أنقذ ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك. We raised your fame يا رسول الله. See how many people around the world. الأذان never stopped. أشهد أن لا إله إلا محمد رسول الله. How many Muslims they said أشهد أن لا إله إلا محمد عبده ورسوله. How many Muslims they are in مدينة مكة. How many Muslims they making صلاة عن رسول الله. Allah raised his fame صلى الله عليه وسلم. ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسرى. إن مع العسر يسرى. It's with the same difficult. It's the same L معرفة بألف لام means the same one. Difficult. Two E's. With one difficult two E's. يسرى يسرى different E's. But L ألف لام in Arabic means the same one معرفة. It's the same العسر. Same difficult. It's only one. يسرى يسرى different E's. فدونت جيف اب. الله از يور جاد اند وين يو كونتاكت يور سيلف وذ هيم يو سي الحمد لله وات ايفر هابن تو مي اي هاف الله ان ماي لايف. الله ويل هيلب مي سام هاو. اي ويل نيفر جونا فيل. اي ام ستاندينج اول ذا تايم بيكوز اي هاف سبورت. هو سبورتينج مي ها. قال كلا لا وزر. دي نو اسم من وزر. وان الله سكيرد اس فروم ذير افتر ذا ديف جادجمنت هي سيد كلا لا وزر إلى ربك يومئذ المستقر. سورة القيامة. وزر means معين helper. There is nobody can help you except your good deeds and the judgment. That's it. وزر comes from the word what even in Urdu we can say it وزير. Do you not say الوزير? الوزير the helper of the president or the helper. كل وزير comes from the word وزر in Arabic. وزر means معين or helper. كلا لا وزر إلى ربك يومئذ المستقر. But as a Muslim Allah سبحانه وتعالى is your helper. That's why we say 17 times in our prayers every day. Huh? When we recite Surah Al-Fatiha, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. Oh Allah, we worship you alone. You are our God. And we seek help from you alone, Ya Allah. You are the one who can help us. Subhanallah. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. That's why, dear brothers, Ramadan is coming. We are in the month of Sha'ban. Wherever you see the masjid, go to the masjid. Train yourself from now to go to the masajid. Train yourself from now to fast more days. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mostly he used to fast the month of Sha'ban and Ramadan. Continue together like that. Why Rasulullah? He said because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is receiving our deeds of the whole entire year in the month of Sha'ban. And I would like Allah to receive my good deeds while I'm fasting. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. See, fast these days, at least Monday, Thursday, train yourself. And the day is still short. Subhanallah, day will be long. Do you know when? 10th of March. One day before the day before Ramadan. The time gonna change, gonna be 1 hour longer in the day. Subhanallah. More ajr, inshallah. But now, the day is still short. As Rabi' al-Mu'min, the spring of the Mu'min. The night is long, the day is short, you can من قيام ليل and you can fast during the day. This is what Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said. That's why come to the masjid, fast, train yourself to make sadaqah, to recite the Quran more. Ramadan is coming. And there is a big gift for you as a Muslim, huh? As a Muslim, when? The night of 15th of Sha'ban. And I love that night the most. يعني I love لايلة القدر first, then I love this night. Do you know why? Because this is the night of forgiveness. رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the night of 15th of Sha'ban Allah عز وجل يطلع إلى خلقه. Allah is looking at his creature whatever he did create. فيغفر لهم جميعا and they will be forgiven without any reason just like that except two types of people. Number one المشرك, the one he is worshipping others with Allah, co-partners, fake gods with Allah سبحانه وتعالى. These people Allah will not forgive them. Second one, and this is hard. Al-mushahin. Who's al-mushahin? When you see that person, his heart is not clean. His heart is full of hatred, jealousy, envy, harm to others. This kind of person, he never forgive others. That's why Allah will not forgive him. Ya akhi brother, forgive your brother, ya akhi. Tonight is the night of Sha'ban. Talk to him. Call him. You never talk to him. He's your cousin. He's your brother. He's someone you know. Mostly the relatives, they fight with each other. because they deal with each other too much. Mostly relatives, subhanAllah, the kinship. That's why Islam said Salat al-Rahim. You don't know, Shaykh, what he did to me. What did he do? He took my money. Was talking about my daughter. Was talking about my wife. The piece of land between me and God, our father lifted us and fighting. Like this, subhanAllah. This kind of people, Allah will not forgive them. While it's free, forgiveness free that night. By the way, the night of 15th of Sha'ban, there is no specific siyam or special ibadah during that night at all. We have two conditions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasul said, what is the two conditions? Worship Allah alone. Ibadat Allah la sharika lah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibadat Allah, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسِكِ وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ My salah, my hajj, my nusik, my life, my death, my ibadah, all belong to Allah and before Allah رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ There is no God but He. There's only one God, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدَ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدُ That's it. There is no God except Allah. There is no creator except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this message for the atheist people, those who are atheists, subhanAllah, there is no, show me any creator. هَلْ تَعْلَمُ لَهُ سَمِيَّةً Is there any God? His name is Allah. Fake God like what they said. They cannot call themselves even Allah. Allah said in Surah Maryam, هَلْ تَعْلَمُ لَهُ سَمِيَّةً The only one God is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dear brothers, dear sisters, try to make good deeds. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was advising Mu'adh ibn Jabal, Sahabi. Mu'adh is a mufti of the Sahaba, أعلم الناس بالحلال والحرام. He said, يا معاذ ألا أدلك على أبواب الخير I want to guide you, يا معاذ to the doors of all خير all good, يا معاذ Tell me, يا رسول الله رسول الله is telling us He said, الصوم جنة الصوم is protection fasting والصدقة تطفئ الخطيئة More you give it charity more you extinguish your خطيئة There is no sin with the charity That's why the mayyit, the deceased when he's in his grave If Allah will give him a chance to come to this dunya, the Quran said that, the Holy Quran said, Allah said in Surah Al-Munafiqun at the end of the surah, this exactly. If Allah will give him a respite, another chance to come to this dunya, it will never gonna happen. He said, Ya Rab, I want to go back to make sadaqah. Huh? To make what? Sadaqah. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, the ayah. La tulhikum amwalukum. La tulhikum amwalukum wa la awladukum an dhikrillah. ومن يفعل ذلك فأولئك هم الخاسرون وأنفقوا مما رزقناكم من قبل أن يأتي أحدكم الموت فيقول ربي لولا أخرتني إلى أجل قريب فأصدق وأكن من الصالحين Oh Allah, just give me respite, give me one more chance I will go back to this dunya. To marry another wife? No. To build another house? No. To get a new car? No. To make hajj? No. To pray? No. To give sadaqah. To give charity? Sadaqah. فأصدق. And then I'm going to be a righteous person. I'm going to be a good Muslim. That's it. Why? Because he saw the reward of the sadaqah. That's why, dear brother, sadaqah تطفئ الخطيئة. And you will be in the day of judgment under the shade of your sadaqah in the day of judgment. وصلاة الرجل في جوف الليل الرسول advised معاذ بن جبل the great عالم of the صحابة أعلم الناس بالحلال والحرام الرسول عليه السلام said the one he knows most amongst the صحابة حلال and the حرام means he's a big مفتي معاذ بن جبل رضي الله عنه الصوم he advised him to fast he advised him to give صدقة and وصلاة الرجل في جوف الليل the prayer of a person sister or the brother in the middle of the night, which is the last third of every night. Tahajjud, Qiyam al-Layl. And Rasulullah was reciting this ayah in Surah Al-Sajda. Tatajafa junubuhum anil madaji'i yad'una rabbahum yad'una rabbahum khawfan wa tama'a wa mimma razaqanahum yunfiqun They are sleeping at night, but little. تتجافى جنوبهم عن المضاجع. They are away from their bed. What they are doing? يدعون ربهم. They are invoking Allah, sending their supplication and du'as to Allah. خوفا with fear of his punishment. وطمعا with hope of his rahmah and mercy and jannah. And they spend. See? ومما رزق. Whatever Allah gives you, ومما رزقناهم ينفقون. That's why don't belittle any good deeds these days. That lady, she entered the hellfire because she put a little cat into the cage without food until the cat died. She entered the hellfire because of that. Another lady, she was a prostitute woman. According to the hadith, she found the thirsty dog. You know all of this hadith. All of you know this hadith. She provides some water to that thirsty dog. Allah forgives her and she made tawbah and she entered Jannah because of that. See, do not belittle any good deed. Try to come close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before Ramadan, اخلعوا ملابس الذنوب والعصيان. Take off these clothes which is you have of sin. التخلية قبل التحلية. Be away from sin. Make tawbah. توبوا إلى الله جميعا. All Muslim ummah, repent to Allah. Do you know why? Because the scholar, they said, if you come, Ramadan comes, while you did not make tawbah, Allah will never gonna give you tawfiq to attend Ramadan. التخلية, you have a guest is coming to your house. You're telling your wife, I need the house to be clean. Prepare the food. Everything must be set on its place. Organize everything. Put perfume, bukhur, light, everything, because I have a special gift. Clean the house very well. This is exactly Ramadan is our guest. You have to clean the house. Clean your heart. Stop sinning. Make general tawbah, all Muslim ummah. And during these days, Allah Azza wa Jalla will accept your dua. Allah will give you tawfiq, inshallah, in Ramadan to stand in Salat al-Tarawih. To read the Quran, to make good ibadah. Brothers, ihna, me and you are going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and death is looking at us. Subhanallah, I don't know I'm going to be in Ramadan or not. You don't know too. This is very close to me and you. And you don't know when. You don't know. Don't tell me I have muscles. I go to gym every day. No. Wallahi, before 2 years, that guy from Lebanon, he was a doctor, just finished his residency. He was, subhanallah, in gym and running. He get heart attack and he die. I attend his janazah. Subhanallah. Young man, taller than me. Subhanallah. Death is coming with or without any reason. You are old or young, it's coming. When your time comes, that's it, done. For that's why don't tell me, because I'm still young. No. Try to make good deeds as much as you can, because فَإِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهُمْ لَا يَسْتَأْخِرُونَ سَاعَةً وَلَا يَسْتَقْدِمُونَ Dear brothers, dear sisters, try again. Do as much as you can, good deeds. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, شهر شعبان, that month is coming between Rajab and Ramadan. When Rajab comes, people are busy with Rajab. When Sha'ban comes, the people they think about Ramadan, they neglect Sha'ban. شَهْرٌ يَغْفُلُ عَنْهُ النَّاسِ And when you worship Allah during the time of heedlessness, while people are in ghafla, Allah will look at you. You are different. Come to me. Allah gonna look at, Allah will give you tawfiq to attend the month of Ramadan, inshallah, while you're making good deeds, بإذن الله عز وجل. Try to do good deeds before Ramadan. Do you know, if you fast before Ramadan, and you make good deeds, special fasting, and subhanAllah, Ramadan will, inshallah, you're going to fast this 30 days or 29 days. After Ramadan, Rasulullah advised us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to fast 60 days of Shawwal. If you fast Ramadan and you follow it with 60 days of Shawwal, the Imams are going to tell you that in Ramadan a lot, especially at the end of Ramadan. As if you fast the whole entire year. SubhanAllah. Allah will count that 60 days as 60. SubhanAllah, 60 days as 60. And that 30 days at 300, gonna be 360 as if you fasted the whole entire year. See how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you. And fasting before Ramadan and after Ramadan, like Sunan al-Mu'akkada before and after Salah. See, Sunan al-Rawatib. Sometimes they pray for Daka'ah before Zuhr and Turak'ah after Zuhr, before and after Salawat, subhanallah, and Farida. For that's why, try to turn your face to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and worship Allah as much as you can. Read the Quran, do good deeds. And inshallah, I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from you. I will end with this hadith. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look what people are doing in the market. They are heedless, right? They are busy with the money, buying, selling, and they're doing business in the market. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, look, he said, if you enter the market and you say this dua, La ilaha illallah. Remember this dua. La ilaha illallah when you enter the market. Why the market? Because people are heedless. They are busy with money. If you say لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو حي لا يموت بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير. If you say this دعاء when you enter the market, you can't get it from the internet. It's easy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we're gonna give you ألف ألف حسنة. الصحابة, they did not know 1 million. Million, this is, we are the one who give this million. مليون they used to say ألف ألف thousand thousand he gonna get thousand thousand حسنة one million حسنة and Allah will wipe out one million sin ألف ألف سيئة will be out wiped out and Allah will raise your rank in Jannah status ألف ألف درجة rank in Jannah one million and you're gonna have house in Jannah like what Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said why because the market is the place of heedlessness people are busy with money and like that the month of Sha'ban the same people are busy with Ramadan Rajab too many things and subhanallah they are heedless about Sha'ban that's why try to do good deeds inshallah train yourself to make good deeds inshallah I'm asking Allah Azza wa Jal dear brother inshallah to give you health and make you wealthy and to give you inshallah tawfiq to attend the Ramadan and to be good Muslim in Ramadan inshallah Rabbil Alameen and I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ya arhamar rahimeen to give nusrah to our brothers and sisters in Gaza ya arhamar rahimeen Allahumma ansur ikhwanana fi Gaza ya Rabbil Alameen Allahumma ansurhum wa kum ma'ahum ya arhamar rahimeen wa fi Filistin wa fi kulli biqa'i al-ard ya Rabbil Alameen